or was it more difficult?
It's always difficult, that's for sure, when you're dealing with time-sensitive issues like recruiting, which are based on relationships, and you start from behind, you have ground to make up. But I think the continuity that we have amongst the staff, the relationships that we have amongst our staff, only help in building those relationships with the recruits and moving forth in that direction. So while it's always a difficult transition, you know, we have been through it before, and we can anticipate the questions, we can anticipate the problems, and that helps in the whole process.
Yeah, to build upon that, I mean, the fact that we've worked together and we're so familiar with each other, that really helps out quite a bit. And the support here at Tennessee is unbelievable. So that certainly makes the transition a little bit smoother as well.
I think too, the fact of us knowing about some of the prospects allowed us to, you know, catch up to speed with exactly where we were in the recruiting of the young men, and again working with each other as we have been for us three the whole time, allowed the transition to be smooth.
You know, I think not to be understated is really, you know, Coach Elder at our previous stop, Coach recruited the entire state of Tennessee and had great relationships with a lot of the coaches and frankly a lot of the recruits. So he was able to come in, he in particular was able to come in with a solid foundation on the personalities of a lot of these guys and share that with the rest of his coaches. So that was also very helpful.
Coach Elder, how was it coming from Cincinnati to Tennessee and recruiting state? How was it different? How are you, I guess, perceived now being in Tennessee?
Well, being the state university, I mean, it's been a great reception. The coaches in this state are remarkable. I mean, they're great people. But when you walk in with the power T on your chest, obviously they're a little bit more welcoming and a little bit more excited to see you. So that was a really good transition and positive.
For Mike Bajakian, just how paramount was it to add talent at quarterback and receiver positions, particularly in the wake of the early exits to the draft and the numbers?
It was very important. You know, it's obviously a lot of production was lost to the NFL, and you always, number one, you always want to create competitive situations. So we feel great with the guys we have on the roster, but anytime you can add talent at any position, particularly as it pertains to the question you asked, at the quarterback positions and at the wide receiver positions, you're only going to improve not just from an overall talent, but you're going to improve. You're going to force the guys that are on the roster right now to step up their game. So we're excited with what we were able to add at both those positions.
Coach Elder, can you talk about Woody Quinn, just how you guys were able to find him and his past and how a volleyball player translates to football now?
Woody's got a great story. He really does. A guy that played high school football early in his career and then really started going down the path of volleyball just because he was a national recruit. He was a big-time guy for volleyball and went that direction but missed football. And through a lot of talking with his parents and some family, friends, and so forth, decided to go back to football. And you watch his film. We watched it and really loved his film. And when we found out that was the first time he had played football in about 5 years, it was a no-brainer to think that this guy who's 6'6", 260 pounds, is playing as well as he is, and he hasn't had shoulder pads and helmet on in 5 years. Remarkable, and I think it's going to be a great story here.
Mike, how open were you guys with Riley? Obviously, quarterback's kind of a unique position, and that if you bring in, you know, more than one in a class, it's kind of odd. How open were you guys with him and that you guys were looking into bringing in another quarterback this class?
Very open. And you know, again, Coach Jones said it's about relationships, and relationships are built on trust. So as soon as it became evident that Tyler Bray was no longer going to be here and that we only had two scholarship quarterbacks on the roster, we called up Riley and addressed the issue and told him, hey, we're going to need to bring in another quarterback. So since early in our arrival, we made that clear and you know, again, just an opportunity to create competition.
Coach Elder, can you describe the relationships between the University of Tennessee and in-state high school coaches? Would you describe it as strained, maybe those relationships a little damaged, and how much work do you think you guys have to maybe build to strengthen those?
Well, I think that we're going to have great relationships in this state because we're going to recruit this state well. We're going to put our emphasis on this state, and we've got great people on the staff. So looking forward, I mean, this is going to be a great relationship within the state, and looking forward to it. And I think that the football here in the state is really good. You can certainly sign a number of guys in the state and win championships with the guys here in the state, and we are going to own this state.
Coach Mahoney, can you just talk about the need to add some numbers on the offensive line in this class after last year, not signing by the offensive front, and talk about a little about the three guys you got?
Yeah, I mean, it was huge coming in with Brett Kendrick already committed and Austin Sanders as well. As Coach talked about the relationships and building that right away with those two guys having a passion for Tennessee and excited and the pride that they have for playing here and that being huge and them staying strong and loyal. Tremendous family and just again their commitment and loyalty here was outstanding. And so we just kept building through the process, both of them. Obviously Brett can play tackle and guard, extremely athletic. Watched him play basketball last week, winning program, back-to-back state champions, things that Coach talked about that we look for in a profile and that excited to have with him having been committed when we came in. Austin Sanders, again, along the same lines, athletic, can play guard and tackle, and one of the first commitments here in this class. And again, a tremendous background with his family. And then Dylan Wiseman, a guy that we've known about for 3 years. And that's the thing about recruiting is it's not just a year or a couple months. It's over a period of time in which, again, you're developing that relationship and trust and knowing them and their families and just working with him for 3 years and knowing his makeup, his work ethic, his values, school being important, all those things is a great addition for us. And those three guys coming in has me extremely excited for the future where we're at.
Mike, having just gone through this process, does it make you look forward to the next recruiting season to know that you'll have an entire year to build relationships?
Sure. It's we've started, had started even before we arrived here, building those relationships with underclassmen. And obviously, today was a great day. I can't tell you how many 2014 recruits we were able to get on the phone with Coach Jones and with position coaches and really start to emphasize our relationship with those guys and grow from there.
Anything else?